This is my barn. It houses my music studio, place where I spend a lot of time writing, as well as just play area for my kids. When we first moved here, we wanted this to be a place that my kids never wanted to leave and that their friends wanted to come to. So let me show you. First thing you'll notice is our doors. These are basically our guest book. So when anyone new would come to the house, come to the barn, the kids would have them signed. People still sign it to this day. So I lost track a long time ago of who all signed it, but it's just a really cool thing that my kids did. And you'll notice we have a lot of playthings. We have foosball, air hockey, pool table, ping pong, half court basketball at one time. And even when we first moved here, I'd let the kids roller skate in here. It was a lot cleaner. It's become storage for a lot of stuff now. Now that I have kids who are married, the married kids store things here. Like one couple's getting ready to move to a new house, so we have their refrigerator and stove and oven and those kinds of things. We've got memories everywhere. This whole wall actually is memory lane, but that wall especially is family pictures from years and years ago that when we retired one family picture, we'd put that, the old one up there. So see every stage of clothing style, every stage of hairstyle, see the twins when they were first born, all the kids growing up. And then directly in front of me is my studio, and I wanted it designed to look like a man cave. A mountain cabin was my actual words to my designer. So I have a lot of my old recordings. One year my wife took all my old recordings and had them framed for me. We've actually recorded like 35 albums now, something like that. I lost track. Some awards, that kind of stuff. But then over here is one of my favorite things. It's my wall of fame. Just a lot of different artists that I've gotten to know through the years and got to minister with. Artists that influenced me. One of my favorite pictures, a picture with me and my hero, Annie Herring. In fact, you'll see a drawing, a watercolor of Annie and my daughter, Annie, who is her namesake. God used Annie Herring in my life to such a degree that I wanted one of my children named after her, just to thank God for what he had done through her life in my life. Come on inside and I'll show you the studio. It's actually become more than just a studio. Let me get a light here. My studio has expanded through the years. I used to have all my gear, all my equipment in this one little 10-foot wide by about 20-foot long area. Everything that you see over here was crammed into this one small space. But I've surrounded myself with pictures of my family, pictures that my children have painted, pictures that my children have taken. I have a daughter who's a photographer. Just surround myself with family because that helps keep me grounded, reminding me really why I do what I do. And one year my kids made me a collage of just early memories of time with them. And nature pictures that my daughter has taken. Picture of President Bush. I wrote President Bush a song one time and somebody got it to him. He sent me back the lyrics to my own song, signed to me. Just another cool thing. And then this is my piano that I've had probably 15 years now. And I record all my demos here on my Mac. When I record here in this studio, it's generally demos. If I want to do a real recording, I'll go to a major studio generally. I've recorded several times in Nashville. I've recorded several times in Dallas. For my duets recording, we recorded literally all over the U.S. to get that thing done. But typically what I do here in my studio is I'll write a new song and I'll do a demo version of it and then post it to YouTube just to see if it's going to minister to people. And so I'm kind of surprised to see that where the music winds up. In fact, songs that I didn't even know people were using, I'm getting royalties from CCLI. So it's kind of cool the way the world operates now. I can write a song and in a day have it posted to YouTube, and then my publisher will have it published online within a week. So it's crazy. From the time I started, when it took a year to get an album and the music out there, now it's almost instantaneous. So I love the way the world is now. I consider myself a song receiver. I just try to practice Psalm 45:1. It says, my tongue is the pen of a ready writer. My heart overflows with a good theme. I address my verses to my king. So my way of writing is I wait till the mood strikes me, but I'm prepared at the drop of a hat to write. I keep my manuscript paper with me. I keep my iPhone with me. Just some way of getting recorded any ideas I have. And typically they're born out of my relationship, not just with God, but my relationship with people. I cry out to God all the time for my friends, for my family. Lord, what are you singing over them? Lord, what is there a song that would help them express their need, their particular circumstance they're going through? Give me a song for them. So everything's relational. It just is.